think of cities as the opposite of nature. But what if we started looking at them as nature of a different kind? Plants and animals already use our buildings and bridges as habitat. And our parks and gardens attract birds, reptiles, and insects. Sometimes these are the species that used to live here long before we arrived. Often they're species that we've brought from somewhere else. And some of them are species that are endangered in their original habitats. Red-crowned parrots were brought to California from Mexico by the tens of thousands for the pet trade in the 1960s and 70s. They're now endangered in their home range, but enough of them escaped that several thousand of them now thrive in eastern Los Angeles. It doesn't mean they're a native species, but it does mean that they're now a permanent part of our urban landscapes. That just happened by luck. But the red-crowned parrots could also offer an inspiring model for opening up our city to other endangered species, those that used to live here, but also species from other places that might find a home in Los Angeles. Spotted turtles, which are endangered on the East Coast, might find an ecological niche here. And so could endangered geckos. In the future, perhaps our cities could serve as urban arks that offer sanctuary to humans and non-humans, natives and non-natives alike.